Hey, hey, hey! Oh! Today, I am going to be doing a review, or a product review, because I ain't done a product review for so long, on these Umberto Giannini products. I picked these up in January sales, in the Boots gift sets range. What attracted me straight away is mega goth mode, was the black bottles, and the really pretty pictures. Now, this came with a tin, and some hairspray and two kind of rubbish looking hair clips which I don't have. I've used the hairspray up and I'm on to these. Now this is a negative review overall, though there are some positives in it. So what we'll do is we'll start with the main negative. So it should have been £20 for the tin. But obviously I got half price because everything's half price in the Boots sale. So it was £10 for the two full-size products and the hairspray and the things. So yeah, I thought, well, I can't really complain at that. Plus the tin's really nice as well. And you also got a comb, like a fishtail comb with a metal end. And I'm always experimenting to see what dry shampoos are the best ones that are around. And I always find that Umberto Giannini stuff, if I'm saying his surname right, always smells amazing. Like their light blue range of products smells like Thierry Mulga Angel. Again, sorry if I'm not saying his name right either. So I thought, well, what's the harm? It's £10, go for it. So this is the morning after dry shampoo. So the first thing I'm just gonna do it just on this other bottle is, it has two lids, right? Now, why? Why do you need two lids? Why do you need this one? And then why do you need this one on top? I just don't understand. It's infuriating. It's a waste of packaging completely. And before the manufacturer goes, we just want to make sure that your product's safe. It's safe because it's already got a lid. So it's totally unnecessary to have a shitty little plastic one underneath. I would rather just have that than this on top or vice versa. It's just completely unnecessary. It's a waste of plastic. And as a person that bums recycling so hard, it infuriates me that there's just so much excess packaging that I can't easily recycle, and it'll just have to, for me, just go in the bin. And that's on all the tinned products, because the dry shampoo was exactly the same. The dry shampoo has a lovely, just shake it up there, and if you can kind of see anything coming out there, yeah. Has a lovely smell, as always, and now it's just like kind of misting over. And it kind of reminds me of Christmas now, well, and New Year because of this. However, it does not last very long. The full price, this is £6, which I do not recommend you ever paying £6 for this. If it's on half price, £3, possibly. After three uses, it was down to here. Now, I'm not like spraying my hair so, like, you know, my hair's not so greasy that I need to use a whole tub. But, you know, a few like nights out and things like that, three goes and it was busy empty. So I just took it back and complained and said, you know, I've used it three times and it's down to here. Like, you could feel it and nothing would come out. You could feel liquid in it, but then nothing would come out of it. And to me, that's rubbish. If, you know, £6 is a lot of money to spend on dry shampoo, considering that I got a really decent one for 99p from Superdrug, which was Superdrug's own brand. So I wasn't really too impressed. But it does make your hair smell amazing. So if your hair is like a greasy swamp pit, yes, it won't make it look clean as if you've just come out of a shower, but it will make it smell nice and last the day. But I would not be buying this again purely because it just doesn't last that long. And to be honest, I haven't had a need to use it for a while because I haven't really been on any nights out and I've not been so trampy and I've been washing my hair. So yeah, but other than that, I would not use this again. If it was a present, yeah, but I wouldn't buy it. The next thing is the back comb in the bottle, also £6 full price. Well, remove this unnecessary packaging. Again, same smell as the other range, and even the hairspray smells like that as well. This is a lot more full. You're supposed to give it a little shake and then spray it approximately 6 inches to where you want to back comb and then zhoosh the hair into shape as you go. What I do is I take a section, I spray it, makes your hair quite wet. Doesn't matter how far away you bring it, makes your hair wet and looks a little bit greasy. But then I come back home and it does kind of add a little bit of a texture to it, which makes your back comb and say, but you're still going to need a load of hairspray obviously hold your back comb in place. Again, I wouldn't buy this again. I think it's unnecessary. And also, there are better products like the, is it the Schwarzkopf Kalki stuff? I bought that from B&M Bargains for 99p or 1.99 or something like that. And I found that that added a lot more volume to my hair. So overall, it's kind of a negative review for me. The packaging's great, the smell's great, but the longevity of the back, the dry shampoo, and just, of this, I just wouldn't buy it again. Really. So you can make your mind up on it. If you want to try it, but I wouldn't bother. So yeah, if you have any questions about either these products or any of the Umberto range from Boots, or what you, if whether or not you like them or not, tell me. Maybe I'm doing something wrong with this one, but it's so meh. Yeah, so leave a comment below. If you liked it, like this video. If you want to see more, comment. But other than that, just subscribe to me and I will see you next time.